I arrived at Blackwood Manor one cold Saturday morning amidst a thick veil of fog. The weather didn't look good, and there was an unnatural calm surrounding the area. Yet, I soon became entangled with the place.
Jerry, it's good to hear your voice.
I see that piece of junk you got there is working.
My thoughts exactly. I was afraid it'd fall apart as soon as I laid my fingers on it.
So how did you find everything? Do you like the place?
It's hard to tell yet. I'm very impressed, that's for sure.
You sound odd. Is everything okay?
Yes, 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 it's perfectly fine. It's just that I'm in awe. I mean, pleasantly surprised. This house is like a dream come true. I'm telling you, I'm going to turn this place into a factory of horror stories.
Good. You ought to finish that book. I'm rooting for you, mate. You sure everything is in order?
Well, I just got here. Let me have a look around, and I'll get back to you if I find anything strange.
Excellent. I'll talk to you later.
Thank you. Thank you.
Jerry, it's me.
What's up, Michael?
Everything seems to be fine, except the lights don't work.
Oh, you don't have to worry. I forgot to tell you. I had an electrician, one that I trust, to meet you there this morning. You know how a lack of power can be a recurring issue in old places like that. He should be arriving soon.
That's good to know. I'll set up my stuff and let you know how everything does later.
Perfect. Have fun.
Sure.
Thank you.
Jerry, we have a problem.
What happened?
The electrician missed me. He left a note in the mailbox.
Bloody hell. He was supposed to meet you at the gates early this morning. I thought he was just being late.
Damn, then I must have missed him for a few minutes. What the heck am I supposed to do now?
Why don't you go check the fuses yourself? Maybe it isn't that serious.
I don't know. I'm not very good with that kind of thing.
Michael, even my grandmother could improvise a fuse. Just go and look, and let me know if you see anything burnt.
As in black spots?
Yes, black spots.
All right, I'm on it.
Thank you.
Seem to be fine. I think the problem might be a little more complicated than that.
I see.
What should we do now?
Go get some candles.
You're joking, right?
No, I'm not. I'm calling this guy right away, and I'm afraid he won't be able to stop by until tomorrow. He was already driving there today as a personal favor.
There must be something you can do. I don't feel comfortable walking around this place with dim lights. I barely know it.
Michael, come on. Where's your sense of adventure? It would be like you were living in a past century. Exquisite Victorian house, lit by candles. What I wouldn't give to be in your place.
I left my sense of adventuring back in London, thanks. I have work to do.
Then do it. What else could you ask for? Now you have the chance to experience firsthand one of your period pieces.
Oh, very funny. Try getting that guy over here as soon as possible.
Don't worry, I will. Make sure you find some candles before it gets too dark.
Yes, candles. Bye.
Hello, Arthate Productions.
Arthate Productions? What in heaven's name was that?
Oh, hi, boss. I was just fooling around.
Well, don't. I don't want people thinking I'm some kind of studio. And don't call me boss.
I'm sorry, it's just that no one was calling, and all of a sudden I got excited.
I told you it was going to be that way, girl. But I still need you there. I just hope you're not being bored to death.
Oh, don't worry. I'm studying tongues during my spare time. I love that so much.
That's great, but don't lower your guard. As soon as I publish my new book, that place is going to get riddled with phone calls and hundreds of fan mail.
That's the spirit, boss. I know your new book is going to be a huge success.
Of course it will. As soon as I find a proper ending. And stop calling me boss.
As you wish, boss. Oh, sorry.
Thanks. Goodbye.
Good luck.
Hey, it's me, Bobby, dear. I need to ask you a favor.
Bring it on.
I found a letter here, and I'm curious about it. It's in Italian. Do you think you could translate it for me?
Why, Mr. Athwaite, are we being naughty?
Mrs. Styles.
Yes, of course I can. Just send me the letter, and I'll put hands to work as soon as I have it here.
Excellent. I wonder if the postman will come by. I feel like I'm the last person alive on the whole planet here.
Blackwood Manor?
Yes, Jerry did. I just hope they don't forget about me, that's all. In any case, thank you. You're such a dear.
That's what I'm here for.
Actually, that's what I'm paying you for. Anyway, I'll go and try mailing that letter.
I'll be standing by for action.
Thanks. Goodbye.
Good luck.
Thank you.
Hey, Jerry.
Michael, did you find yourself some candles?
No, not yet. This place is huge.
Well, keep looking.
Sure. Bye.
Thank you.
freaking out. I couldn't find a single candle inside this place.
You're kidding me. I can't believe it. Did you look well?
Yes, every single room, drawer, box, cabinet, nothing. No candles.
All right, listen. The town isn't too far away. No more than 20 minutes drive. If you can't find some candles there, I'll eat my hat.
You'll eat your whole closet. This is getting on my nerves.
Come on, it's just a quick ride. You know how to get there?
Yeah, I saw it on my way here. Did you call Mr. Busy Electrician, who couldn't hold on for just 5 more minutes?
Yes, he'll be doing me another special favor, and we'll be going there tomorrow afternoon. It's the best he can do. You have to bear in mind it's Sunday. We'll charge extra, of course.
I don't care. I have no power. I'll get him myself if he doesn't show up.
Calm down. Drive to the town before it gets too dark. You won't be able to find your way back if it does.
Yeah, I had to buy some food anyway.
There you go. Godspeed. And drive safe.
You won't believe this. It's insane. My car is dead.
What? Are you sure? Have you checked his pulse?
I'm not joking. It's gone.
My friend, this completely redefines the term suspension of disbelief you sometimes use for your stories.
I know. I'm speechless. I forgot the lights on and the car ran out of batteries. All because of that bloody fog. Jerry, you've got to help me. Get over here.
Michael, look at the time. I can't drive to Northumberland right now.
But, Jerry, I can't spend the whole night without one single source of light. I barely know this place, and I won't be able to find my way. Heck, I don't even know if it's rid of ghosts yet.
Are you a sleepwalker, Michael? You lie down on the bed, you sleep, you wake up, and you'll have tons of bright light then.
That's not helping. And you're the one who got me into this mess in the first place.
Hold on a minute. It's not my fault if the electrician missed you for a few minutes. There aren't any candles in a 3-story mansion, and your car's battery was low.
Okay, listen. When will you be coming back to Rothbury?
I'll be arriving home early tomorrow morning, and I'll come for you shortly after. We'll drive to town, stock yourself up, and then spend the rest of the day in your garden, drinking some beers while we wait for Mr. Electrician. Sounds like a plan?
Yeah, I guess. And I don't think there's any plan B either.
I'm afraid not. Sorry. I really took all the precautions to make your stay there as comfortable as possible. But I guess sometimes things are just meant to go wrong.
Apparently. All right. I'll be on my way then.
Call me back if you need anything. And Michael?
Yes?
Just don't let this situation get on your nerves.
I promise it won't. Goodbye.
Thank you.
Jerry, it's me.
What's up, Michael?
Do you know anything about the previous inhabitants of this house?
Not much. Just there were some strange individuals. There's also the murder.
You're kidding me. A murder?
An old-fashioned murder. You'd probably love the details, but sadly I don't know very much. It's old history, really. Although it caused quite a stir there in Rothbury. It seems the owner, James Blackwood, I think, went mad and killed his wife. I do remember the date, though. May 1963.
James Blackwood, according to the stuff I've been reading.
Oh, so you're already turning the place upside down? I should have thought so.
There's enough material for a whole series of stories here, you know.
After you finish your book, my friend.
Yeah. But it can never hurt poking around a little.
Would you just get back to work? Call me if you need anything.
All right. Goodbye.
Hello?
Jerry, it's me.
What's up, Michael?
I found a safe box in a room upstairs. Would you happen to know the combination?
I think I should. Let me see. I did take note of a combination once, but I don't have it here right now. I'll give it to you tomorrow. Okay?
Great. Thanks.
Hit there too. Seems the entire universe is falling here. I'm afraid to go outside.
Well, the better then, as I won't be able to come for you. I'm deeply sorry, but it's seemingly impossible driving to Northumberland. Even less getting anywhere near the manor. I understand many of the roads are closed.
So much for my hopes of seeing Mr. Electrician today, then. The benefits of being away from society, eh? I should have listened to you. It's not like I have another choice, do I?
I'm afraid not, my friend. This storm has the power to disturb the dead.
Well, it seemed like this very same storm has awakened the evil spirits resting inside my new home.
What's that?
Not sure, but I happened to hear some odd sounds last night. Kind of scratching noises down in the basement.
I do remember the cleaning lady saying something about rats.
Unless we're talking about mutant rats here, I don't think that's the problem.
Michael, my friend, you were tired from a long trip and stressed about the problems you found there. On top of that, you had moved to a very old house. Guess what's the most common complaint from people moving to old houses?
Ghosts on the loose?
Sort of. Now go focus on your book while you still have enough light. I'll be there as soon as possible. By the way, Michael, I have the combination for the safe right here.
Oh, great. Tell me.
03211. Just remember to share it if you bump into any expensive jewelry.
Of course I will. Bye.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Jerry, it's me. You won't believe what I've found here.
Try me.
It's about the happenings that led to the murder you told me about. There's an impressive backstory surrounding this place and many loose ends. It would seem nobody ever stumbled upon this.
Shouldn't you be working on your book?
Are you listening to me? James Blackwood was into some very weird stuff and possibly dangerous. Something tells me this case is much more complex than it was thought to be.
Why don't you inform the authorities? I'm sure they'll be dying to reopen a long-forgotten case about some crazy old psycho killing his wife.
No way. And miss all the fun? I'm doing this on my own. I wonder if those noises I heard have anything to do with this. Maybe James Blackwood was trying to hide something.
Like in that book, where an old man was guarding the entrance to hell. I bet this James Blackwood person had a doorway like that in his basement. Those dreadful noises must be the sound of the damned coming for you.
Why, thanks, mate. That's been very helpful. Great to have friends like you.
Then stop talking about all this nonsense. Do you have any idea how crazy it sounds? You're a writer, not some fancy PR.
I'll get to the bottom of this. I know I will. I'm certain there's much more to James Blackwood than a simple act of murder.
Now you're sounding more morbid than usual. Simple act of murder? Oh, goody. Just somebody died. Nothing to worry about. This isn't like you, Michael. This whole thing is really affecting you.
Stop being a drama queen. I'm a grown-up, and I'm pretty aware of what I'm doing.
Fine. Go chase around the ghosts of James Blackwood. I'll stay here in the real world.
I'll let you know about my progress.
Thank you.
It's me.
The ghost hunter. Any contact with the other world yet?
Actually, I'm not sure. Jerry, I'm definitely not alone in this house.
What are you talking about?
Last night I saw something down below. It was moving. I wasn't dreaming, and I'm not making this up.
Are you sure it wasn't a mutant rat?
Definitely no rat.
I'm calling the police.
No, not just yet.
Michael, for Christ's sake, you could have a burglar inside the house.
This is no burglar, Jerry. It's much more interesting than that, and I want to figure this out by myself.
Have you taken leave of your senses?
Just promise me you won't call anyone. I can do this on my own.
Whatever. Just call me if you need any help. I'm driving there today.
Right. Bye.
day, the National Bank of Northumberland. Robert Blake speaking.
Hello, Robert. I need some help. It's about James Thomas Blackwood. Do you have a customer called that?
I'm sorry, sir. I can't give you that kind of information.
My name is Christopher Milton, a renowned doctor and good friend of the Blackwood family, and I demand some respect.
All right, sir. Please, just hold on for a few moments. Ah, yes. I have a customer listed as James Blackwood here.
Good. I need to know about any recent banking activity in this account.
What kind of banking activity, sir?
Well, you tell me. Any withdrawals, payments?
Look, sir, I'm really sorry, but I can only give that information to Mr. Blackwood himself.
So that means the account is still active?
Well, yeah. It means I can't give you this information, sir. You said your name was...
I won't waste your time anymore. Good day.
Thank you.
worried about you. Are you doing okay?
Yes, I'm fine. And I think I know the identity of my intruder.
Tell me. Who is it?
James Blackwood.
The Blackwood person? Michael, are you serious? That the ghost of the murderer is roaming the house?
I'm not talking about his ghost, Jerry. I'm talking about him.
What the heck do you mean?
I mean James Blackwood himself, alive, in this house.
What? How is that possible?
It makes sense. After murdering his wife and realizing what he has done, he begs for help to Christopher Milton, who fakes his death.
Milton? The previous owner? Michael, you're losing your mind. Even if he managed to hide himself, how did he survive all this time? Milton has been missing for years.
Good point, but I'm sure a desperate man like Blackwood would have found a way.
Yes, by turning into a ghost. Wait a minute. I have it right here. James Blackwood passed away on June 1963. Would you please stop this?
Jerry, just listen to me. I know I'm right. There's only Mrs. Blackwood's body in the crypt. His is missing.
Oh, God, Michael. You've really gone out of your mind. Digging into coffins, what next? Desecrating the chapel?
Whatever it takes to solve this mystery. You can only find stories like this in books.
Precisely why I'm beginning to wonder about your sanity.
You'll see.
Thank you.
you Mr. William Bailey?
That's me. And you are?
Yes, my name is Michael Arthate. I'm a journalist for a local newspaper in Rothbury.
I see. And what's this all about?
Well, you're the former police chief of this town, aren't you?
Indeed. I served many years ago.
And you were once in charge of a famous, or should I say, infamous case here?
Bloody hell. Don't tell me this is about James Blackwood.
Well, yes. I'm writing a story for my newspaper. The most famous police cases of Northumberland.
Have you got any idea how many times I've talked about this? Go to your nearest library. I'm sure you'll find plenty of information about Blackwood there.
Please, Mr. Bailey, I beg you. It won't be the same if I can have the information from someone who was there, and no less than the renowned William Bailey of Rothbury.
All right, son, spare me the nonsense. What is it you want to know?
Well, in the first place, what did Ava Mariani see exactly?
She saw enough, son. James Blackwood was dragging a shape into a hole in the garden. At first, Mrs. Mariani couldn't realize what it was, but eventually she made out the dead body of Catherine Blackwood with a serious wound.
And Blackwood was automatically deemed guilty?
He was found digging his wife's son.
Why did James Blackwood never appear before a jury?
When you're someone as renowned and famed as James Blackwood was, you can pretty much avoid the authorities. However, you can't avoid justice. And justice was brought upon James Blackwood.
Justice? How?
He died shortly after the accusation. You should know about that.
What happened to Dr. Christopher Milton?
How should I know? You bet your life that slimy worm was up to something. I couldn't prove it, though I spent years investigating him. A shame we couldn't implicate him as much as James Blackwood.
Are you saying he could have had something to do with the murder?
Blackwood and Milton were very intimate. Milton did the impossible to aid his friend and even clear his name after he died.
And was ever determined the cause of death of Catherine Blackwood?
Yes, partly. Mrs. Mariani managed to see her throat was slit open. Ripped, she would say. It must have been horrible for the poor girl.
Still, everything sounds so vague, as if something were missing.
Are you questioning my performance on this case, son?
No, sir, not at all. I'm just trying to figure this out. Like, why a proper autopsy was never done.
An autopsy to whom?
Please, sir, this is very important to me, and I could really use your help. I'm trying to fit all the pieces of this mystery together.
Mystery? What mystery? You must be one of those people that just love splitting hairs, don't you?
I don't think I understand, sir.
Listen, son, that cold-blooded bastard murdered his wife, God knows why, but he and his fancy doctor did the impossible to hamper our investigations. You don't have to be a brilliant detective to realize Blackwood did it.
There's always a reason behind a murder. Nobody has ever found out why Blackwood did what he did.
Psychopaths don't need any reasons, and James Blackwood turned into one, precisely.
There's got to be something else. I can't believe Blackwood flipped just like that one sunny day. It doesn't make any sense.
People flip, son. You could be flipping right now without knowing it.
Well then, tell me how Blackwood reacted when you pulled his wife from beneath the ground.
I beg your pardon?
I mean Catherine Blackwood's body when you dug in the garden of the manor.
Like I said, they hampered the investigation. We never managed to set one foot inside the manor. What kind of bloody journalist are you, son?
But are you telling you never actually retrieved the body?
That's exactly what I'm telling you. Now, if you don't mind.
But wait, this doesn't make any sense.
Stop wasting my time, dammit. I was enjoying my retirement until you had the brilliant idea of calling me. I don't want to hear anything else about this case ever again.
Please, Mr. Bailey, don't...
Leave me alone. so. Yes?
Jerry, it's me.
Michael, I was about to call you.
Why?
I've been thinking about what you told me. And you could be onto something there. But I'm worried about your safety now. This could be dangerous.
What do you mean by dangerous?
Well, let's suppose you're right. And James Blackwood is indeed hiding somewhere inside the house. He's a madman, a murderer. And your life could be in danger.
Jerry, if James Blackwood is still alive, he'd be nothing more than a harmless, decrepit old man. I don't think I'd have any problem outdoing him.
And what if he is armed?
I'm willing to take that risk. He surely knows I'm here by now. What if he's waiting for me to leave so that he can escape? I can't miss this opportunity.
The opportunity of what, for Christ's sake?
Of knowing. I'm already too much into this, Jerry. And if I don't know what happened inside this house, I won't be able to sleep again.
You're obsessed. You were supposed to finish your book, get some rest, and now look at this. What are you going to say to your editor?
Who knows? Maybe this whole episode inspires me to write that ending. I'm sorry. I can't leave this now, Jerry. It's too late.
I can't believe this. I don't understand you. Doesn't the possibility of spending another night in that house with a creepy old man hiding in the basement scare you?
I know what you're trying to do. Goodbye, Jerry.
Michael? Michael! It's dangerous. Do you hear me? Dangerous! You have to leave that place.
I'll keep you informed.
Thank you.
Unsure of what I had just seen, I raced my car and left Blackwood Manor as quickly as possible. I'm not ashamed of what I did. That disfigured face is still stalking my nightmares, and I've never put foot inside a Victorian house ever since. But there's certainly one thing that I'm grateful for. It was thanks to my encounter below that house that I was able to finish my book and become a prolific writer.